Hey guys, and welcome back to the Santa Spricks. My name is Jevin, and today we're going to be building a Lego Blurrg from the Mandalorian Season 1. So, let's get building.
So starting off at the bottom of the Blurrg, we're going to need a bunch of these 2x2 inverted bracket pieces. You can see that these have studs on the side, which are going to be really useful later on.
So as you can see, here I have these inverted brackets all lined up, and then behind these we're going to add these 1x1 inverted brackets, and then some 1x2 inverted brackets, just like so. Now on top of these, we're going to add a 2x8 plate directly in the middle, and then we're going to add a 2x2 inverted sloped brick on the very end, just like so. So now onto that red 2x8 plate, we're going to add a 2x6 light gray plate and a 2x2 dark gray plate. Now on top of that light gray plate, we're going to add a 2x6 red brick. And then on top of the 2x2 dark gray plate, we're going to add another 2x2 dark gray plate. So now into this gap here, we're going to add a 2x3 dark gray plate and then a 1x2 dark gray plate, but it has this small ball and socket joint on the end. So now on top of those, we're going to add two of these 1x2 plates with the socket in it, and then behind those, we're going to add a 2x2 plate. So next, we're going to add two of these 2x4 dark gray plates, and you'll notice that on the end here, I have one stud sticking out. So then behind those, we're going to add a 1x2 light gray plate and then a 1x2 dark gray plate. Then behind those, we're going to add these snot bricks with studs on two sides. Now, snot stands for studs not on top, which means it has studs on the sides, as you can see here and here. So now onto the front, we're going to add a 2x3 plate and a 2x2 plate. So then behind those, we're going to add two of these 2x4 light gray plates on top of each other, just like that. And now in this little gap here, we're going to add two of these snot bricks, but they have the little lip on the end, and we're going to put one of those on each side facing out. So now onto the front part here, we're going to add a 2x2 plate and a 2x3 plate, just like that. And then in the very front, we're going to add a 1x2 plate, just like so. So now to the front here, I'm going to add these bracket pieces. Then in front of those, I'm going to add these inverted bracket pieces. Then on the back here, I'm going to add more of these bracket pieces, just like so. Then on the back, we're going to put a 2x2 sloped tile, a 2x2 regular tile, and a 1x2 regular tile. So now in the middle here, we're going to add a brown jumper plate, and on top of that, we're going to add one of these round tiles, but it has the little bar piece coming out of the middle. Then in the front, we're going to add a 2x4 plate, and then on top of it in the front, we're going to add a 2x2 plate. Then we're going to use these 2x2 curved plates to make this look nice and smooth. Just like so. So then on this little overhang of this slope here, we're going to add two 1x2 plates. Just like that. Then in this next hole here, we're going to add two of those snot bricks with a little lip at the bottom, but you'll notice that I've put these little eye tiles on them. So we'll put one of these on each side facing out for the eyes of our Blurrg. Then underneath that, we're going to add a 2x2 plate and then two of these inverted brackets, just like so. Next, we're going to take these 1x1 brackets and put them in this little spot right here. Then we're going to take some snot bricks and put them with the stud facing out of our Blurrg, just like so. Now, to the bottom of that, we're going to add this piece here. As you can see, it is a snot brick, and it has two studs right there, and that's going to fit into this spot, just like so. Then behind that, we're going to take two more of these 1x1 bracket pieces, just like so. Then beneath those, we're going to add a 1x2 plate. Then we're going to add four of these white studs to the bottom of this piece here. Then to the bottom, we're going to add a 2x2 plate, just like so. And then onto that, we're going to add a 1x2 plate on this piece right here. And then we're going to add two of these inverted sloped plates onto the front part right here. Just like so. So now to these studs in the front here, we're going to take a 2x1 plate, and then on top of that add a 2x2 slope, and this is going to go on those top two studs, just like so. Then we're going to take a 1x2 cheese wedge piece, and that's going to go beneath this piece here. Next, we're going to need a 2x2 curved tile, and that is going to go onto these two studs right there. Next, we're going to take this little L-shaped plate, and then on top of that, we're going to take a 1x4 curved tile, and then a 1x2 curved tile. Then this piece is going to go onto the side of our Blurrg, just like so. So next we're going to take a 2x4 dark gray plate and put that on these studs here. Now on top of that, we're going to put a 2x2 tile with one stud in the middle. And then on either side of that, we're going to add a 1x4 curved tile, just like so. Then to fill in these gaps here, we're going to take two of these 2x1 cheese wedge pieces and put them on the top and bottom, just like so. Next, we're going to take a 1x2 plate and then a 1x4 sloped tile, and we're going to put this piece right here. Then we're going to take another 1x2 tile and then a 1x2 curved slope, and then a 1x2 curved slope, but it has this cut corner. And this piece is going to go right here, just like so. Then, just like over here, we're going to take a 1x2 cheese slope piece and put it on the studs below and above, just like so. And then actually we're going to take one more 1x2 cheese wedge piece and put it on this stud here, just like so. So now let's do that last part again, but on the other side. So now on the back, we're going to take a 1x2 cheese wedge piece and put it on these two studs here, just like so. So now for the tail of our Blurrg, we're going to start off with this piece here with the socket in it. And then to the bottom of that, we're going to put one of these inverted slope pieces and then a 1x1 plate, just like so. Then to the back of this, we're going to add a 1x2 plate with a hinge piece on it, and then over here, we're going to add two of these 1x1 plates, just like so. And then finally, to the top, we're going to add a 1x3 sloped piece, and now this whole section will click into this ball on the back of our creature, just like so. So now for the next tail segment, we're going to need a hinge piece, and then on top of that, we're going to put a piece with the clip for the hinge, and then we're going to add a tile on top of that, and this will connect to our previous tail segment. Then for the tip of the tail, we're going to take a 1x1 clip piece, and on top of that put a 1x2 sloped tile, and this will connect to the tip of our tail, just like so. So next we're going to build the arms of our Blurrg. So first we're going to start off with a 1x1 clip piece, and on top of that we're going to add a 1x2 sloped tile. Then we're going to need a 1x2 plate with the hinge piece on it, and then we're going to take another clip piece and another sloped tile. just like so. Then we can connect these together and connect it to our Blurrg using this stud here.
So now let's do the same thing for the other side. So next we're going to need to make the legs of our Blurrg. So now that we're done with the arms, we're going to move on to the bottom of our Blurrg. First off, we're going to take a 2x3 inverted sloped brick and put it right here. Then we're going to need to take two of these inverted sloped pieces and connect them using these plates here. Just like so. Then to the bottom of this, we're going to add a brown plate, and then this will connect right next to our inverted sloped brick. Now for the saddle of our Blurrg, we're going to need a 1x1 brown plate and then a 1x3 sloped piece, and we're going to make two of these. Then we're going to put one of these on each side, connecting to these two studs here. Just like so. So now it's time to make the legs of our Blurrg. So starting from the bottom, we're going to need two of these 2x1 inverted sloped bricks. Then to the top of those, we're going to take an inverted bracket and put it on each one. Then we're going to take a 1x2 plate and then put a 1x4 slope on top of it, and then we're going to use these to connect the inverted brackets together. Just like so. Then on top of those inverted brackets, we're going to take a 1x2 plate with the hinge piece on it, and then a 1x2 plate with the ball on it for our ball and socket joint. And then on top of those, we're going to take this piece here, which has a cheese wedge slope on it, and that's going to go on top of our ball and hinge piece, and then we're going to take a 1x3 slope piece to go on top of the whole thing. So for the foot, we're going to start off with a 2x2 round piece, and then on top of that, we're going to add a 2x2 domed piece with one stud in the middle. Now to that, we're going to add one of these snot bricks with the little lip at the bottom, and in the back of this, you can see there actually is a little hole, which will connect to the top of our dome, just like so. Then on top of that snot brick, we're going to add a clip, just like that. And that clip will then connect to the hinge piece in our upper leg to make our completed leg and foot. So now we're going to need to build another one of these, but you'll notice that this one is opposite the first one. So now that we have our legs, we can attach them to our Blurrg. So these ball pieces are going to connect into these sockets just like so, and that's going to go on either side of our Blurrg, giving us this as a result. So now our Blurrg is almost done. The only thing left to add is the rider. So here you can see we have our Mandalorian minifigure, but we're going to need to take a part off of him. So this top part of the minifigure we're going to keep, but then for the legs, we're going to need to take them off of the hips to use them for our Blurrg creation. So like I said before, the top half of our minifigure is going to go on these studs here, just like so. And then these leg pieces that we took off of the hips are going to connect to this stud in here, just like so. And we'll do the same thing on the other side, so that we end up with this. So now we're almost done with our Blurrg. The only thing left to add is the reins. So on the bottom of our Blurrg, we're going to take two of these studs with the hole in the middle and put them on top of this brick here. Just like so. Now into those holes, we're going to add these clip pieces, just like this. And then finally, into those clips, we're going to add this rein piece here. Now we're going to take this bottom part and it's going to connect into these clips here, just like so. So you can see I've taken the top parts of that rein and connected them to the Mandalorian's hands so that he is holding the reins. And so, there we have our Lego Blurrg. Alright guys, and so that is our Lego Blurrg from the Mandalorian. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I really hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to click subscribe right down there.